Twist and Shout from the Grade 2 Electric Guitar Syllabus from Trinity. Another really cool track. So with this one, I think we should just look a couple of things because it's very, very repetitive. Okay. First thing, the opening kind of riff that's all of our verse. Okay. Not that hard to play. Play this rise, open, first finger, third finger, open, D, G, rest, A, and then just keep that A down until you get back to that riff. The most important thing really with this, just to say, is just make sure you're strumming the right number of strings. I would alternate for that opening riff. And then on the G, down, up, and then just down to... That's it for absolutely ages. Let's do that together just quickly. We'll do it slowly. I'll count you in, and your counting's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, 2, 3. Repeat. Don't forget the staccato markings. Staccato, staccato. So you're cutting those notes short, yeah? Now, you need to be aware of how many times you're doing it, so probably you should count that. You're doing it twice, and then the vocal comes in, and then it's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you repeat. So the first time bar, you repeat back to the beginning of the verse, do it 1, 2, 3 more times, and then on the fourth time... It doesn't do the rise. It just stays on that A chord, and then hit the A5 underneath. And then you're going into the instrumental. Now, the instrumental, the first note and the last two notes of the riff are staccato. So it's... Remember your rests and just cut those short, and you do it four times. Okay, then you're into your vocal build. Now, at this point, the vocal build starts with one note. You could alternate that if you want, or you could do all downstrokes. Shake it up, baby. Okay, so just remember you're waiting for the shake it up, baby. And then you're going back to the verse because you've got the DSL coda. Now, that crescendo marking is going to last from mezzo piano to forte. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's 4 bars long, that crescendo, so make sure it lasts for 4 bars. Don't get too loud too quickly. Make that a nice gradual thing. If you're unsure of how it should sound, listen to the full mix or listen to the playthrough, which we'll hear in about a minute. Okay, DSL coda, go back to the verse. Play through, okay, with repeat, so it's exactly as you did before. And then at the end, in the second time bar, so you got... You're going to jump straight to the coda. Back to this. 1, 2, 3, 4, triangle, triangle, 1, 2, 3, 1. So here what we're doing is we're playing 3/2 in essence. You're doing a crotchet or a quarter note triplet over the standard quarter note. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, da 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 da. Now in your head, if you just count that as you could count it 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. Two, or say the word triangle or lemonade or triplet, any three syllable word will work. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Okay? And that is it. It's cool. It's nice. Think about what feels best for you in terms of alternating. We're not going to stipulate absolutely everything. Everyone plays slightly different. Some people play with fingers, some people play with plectrum, some people play with just a thumb. I think with a lot of this stuff, really, you know, if you're coming from a classical background, that's my background originally, you do need to learn to use a pick. because it's going to completely change the way you play and the sound that you get from your guitar, and some of these things just need it. Anyway, have a go through with your teacher, and we'll see you in the next video. But for now, here is the playthrough.